Good morning. My name is Lynn Brandenberger. I work for Oklahoma State University in the Department of Horticulture and Landscape Architecture. Today we're going to talk for a little while about drip irrigation. We use drip irrigation in most of our research because it's a very efficient way to water. It's about 90% efficient compared to an overhead system, which might be 65-70% efficient at best. So it's a very good way to use your water efficiently. That comes into play particularly in situations where, say, maybe we have a well that we're irrigating out of and we don't have a lot of volume of water. Let's say maybe we can get 10 gallons a minute or 5 gallons a minute. We can take a drip system and use that small amount of water and get our crops watered. Whereas if we were using overhead irrigation, we need a lot more water than that just to make the irrigation system work. So it's a very efficient means. Now today we've got several things we want to show you. One is we're here at where we get our water source. It comes, we're on rural water right here. And to begin with, we have a water controller or automatic controller, and this is electronic. That's about, you know, $30-$35 for that. That saves us a lot of problems. Before we had timers, like this timer, we would turn the water on and ask someone to shut it off, or we were going to shut it off, and then we would forget and we would overwater. So we had a lot of problems with that. This timer has stopped all that problem. You can see the supply hose coming out of the timer and it goes into our fertilizer injector. This fertilizer injector actually is a swimming pool chlorinator, and this whole setup here, I think the last one we built was about $125-$130. So it's a cheaper way to do it. The only problem with this is you put the dry fertilizer in here into this kind of tank, and we can put about 3 pounds of fertilizer in that. So we can't put a whole lot of fertilizer on at once. So what we're doing is we're applying a little bit of fertilizer many times to get the total amount of fertilizer that we need for our crop. So that fertilizer would go in there. Here's the screen filter, and this is just a 100 mesh screen, and it's a simple filter. And occasionally we take that apart and clean it, but that should be the last thing coming out of the fertilizer injector, because if we have a little bit of fertilizer that might precipitate, things don't quite work out, this screen filter will catch that and not run it on down into the water system, into the drip tape, and clog it up. So that's kind of this system here, and you can see it's pretty simple and relatively inexpensive. And it's important when we're fertilizing with drip, because we're just putting fertilizer right where the plant needs it. And so the weeds are getting a lot less fertilizer and water than they would if we were overhead watering and then broadcasting fertilizer over the top of the crop. So it's more efficient use even for fertilizer. So we're back at our timers here, and you can see that we can just hit manual to get this started up. We're going to fire this line up here, and you can hear the water starting now, and then it will fill this lay flat. We like lay flat because when we're not watering, we can actually drive tractors or other equipment over it as long as it's not sharp, and it allows us to do that. That's the beauty of this system. So you can see the water starting to fill up there, and it'll start going down the drip tapes here in just a second, because it's almost full. So we've got our successful installation here, and now we're able to water our cowpeas, which will make them very happy. So today we've really visited about the fertilizer injector and how that works, and also the importance of having a screen filter on that to protect your drip system. And we've also shown you a little bit about how water timers work and how the water comes out of the drip tape. If you have any questions, feel free to contact your county extension office. And if they have questions, they can contact us and we'll be glad to work with you. Have a great day, and thanks for listening.